It's time. I'm officially picking these Milwaukee Bucks to win the Eastern Conference and go to the finals. And you might be thinking, oh, you're just saying that because you're a Bucks fan, you're biased. And I am a Bucks fan, so that does mean I am biased. But throughout the majority of the season, when people have asked me, who do you think is going to come out of the East? I've had to say that Kevin Durant, James Harden, Kyrie with Joe Harris and DeAndre Jordan at a time, LaMarcus Aldridge and Blake the Snake, all those role players, Bruce Brown hooping. I had to say, I think they're going to come out of the East. But as the season has moved on, I've gained faith in these Bucks, and I think they're going to win the Eastern Conference Championships based on what I've seen down the stretch. Now, the Bucks do have the hardest path to the finals. I think that they have a harder path than any other team that has to go through. And that sounds crazy maybe because they're in the Eastern Conference and normally people think of the Eastern Conference as just being a lot weaker. And even this year, probably people think of that. And in terms of 1 through 8, you're probably right. In terms of record 1 through 8, yes, it probably is weaker. But the Bucks have a gauntlet. They have the 6th seed. I think this is going to be a popular upset for the people to pick the Miami Heat to beat the Bucks. And some people are saying, Giannis can't get it done in the playoffs. But I think that's a too simple of a way to look at it. Yes, a lot of times with good regular season teams don't get it done in the playoffs, the star player is to blame. But it's not that simple with these Bucks. Going into this season, my only goal for the Bucks, I don't care if you get the 1 seed. You've gotten the 1 seed, I believe, 2 or 3 years in a row now. You've shown that you can get it done. Giannis, you've shown 2-time MVP, you could put up those big numbers. But you need to play a play style that can work in the playoffs. You can't just give the ball, inbound the ball to Giannis, and have him run, slice through the defense. You can do that in games of the regular season. This year, they probably could have done that and gotten the 1 seed easily, especially with teams playing with so many injured players. They would not have been able to put together a wall to be able to stop Giannis and rotate around this year if Giannis was playing that style. But credit to Budenholzer, they actually switched up their offense a good amount. And their defense, which hurt their record, especially to start the season as they were adjusting, bringing the new guys in and playing this new style. But there's still remnants of the old system. It's not completely switching the entire system, but you're starting to see Giannis play a lot more in the post. So it's going to be hard for the Heat to be able to just wall up on him like they did last year. Play him through the post, and it's going to be easy kickouts. And the difference is, last year, when Giannis was healthy, the guys that he had around him, Eric Bledsoe, every single season that they've lost in the playoffs, go look at the stats of the round they lost. He was atrocious in all of them. I'm not trying to go at that man, but he was bad. He shot 21% in that series against the Heat when they were just letting him shoot threes. Now you replace that with Drew Holiday, who, of course, is seen as the best guard defender throughout the league by most. Eric Bledsoe was a good guard defender, but he wasn't that level. And a guy that shoots 38% from three, that's a big upgrade. And now you're replacing Wesley Matthews, who has struggled to get minutes for the Lakers this year, with Bryn Forbes. And that takes me to the X factor for the Bucks. My X factor for these Milwaukee Bucks is Bryn Forbes. He shot 45% from three, and I know a lot of Bucks fans, you know, they believe in Bobby Portis or PJ Tucker to be the X factor. But that's why they're not. Because for me, the Bucks have so many options at the forwards. They're going to be fine if one of them isn't playing well. PJ Tucker can't play well. Like, against the Nets, he could not guard KD at all. And he wasn't hitting many shots. But they won both regular season games because they have options to cover up in the front court. And to close games in the front court, you could go Giannis, Brooke, K-Mitty. You could go K-Mitty, Giannis, PJ, K-Mitty, Giannis, Bobby. You could even move K-Mitty to 2 and go big with PJ, Giannis, and Brooke. But against the Nets where they go small, you're probably not going to do that. So that's why Bryn Forbes is my X factor. Because the one thing, if the Bucks don't get it done this year, my prediction is it's going to come down to the guy that's closing games at the 2 might not be able to get it done and might not be a guy that should be closing big playoff games. Because Dante DiVincenzo, I like him. I like him as a nice role player. When he's hustling like he did against the Nets, I believe he had 15 rebounds one of those games, and just focusing on being that guy and not trying to, you know, create his own shot, I like him a lot. But down the stretch, when close games, playoff time, I don't know if I trust him. I think it's going to have to be Bryn Forbes closing some games, And I think if they do close games with him and he plays as he did the regular season, I think that is going to be the biggest factor for the Bucks outside of their star players. But against the Heat, you're replacing Wesley Matthews with him this year. Wesley Matthews, you shot 30% from three this year. And, of course, I talked about him with the Lakers now. And Marvin Williams with P.J. Tucker. I know a lot of people are just going to simplify to, Giannis isn't getting it done! But I think if you switch the team around him, I believe that the Bucks will handle the Heat in 5 or 6. But that takes us to the Brooklyn Nets. And defeating that team is going to be a daunting task. But I believe this Milwaukee Bucks team is actually the best built team in the entire league to be able to beat the Nets. And I think it's simply because they have three guys that they're not going to be the same level of names. You know, Jrue Holiday is not going to get the shoe deals Kyrie's getting. He's not the name that Kyrie is. And you know what? He's not the star level player that Kyrie is. Same with Chris Middleton, James Harden. Not at all. I get you. It's not the same. But it's three two-way players. Jrue Holiday, again, none of those guys on the Nets are getting locked up. But put him on Kyrie or James Harden, whoever's killing you the most, he's going to be able to do the best job out of anybody in the league. If you don't believe me, listen to star players talk. The interviews that when they ask him who's the best defender in the league, Kevin Durant has said it himself. Jrue Holiday does a good job on him. So if he's getting going, you could put Jrue Holiday on him. Chris Middleton guarded Kevin Durant the first two games, and I feel like he missed the majority of his shots. He did a great job guarding Kevin Durant. Now, when P.J. Tucker went in and guarded Kevin Durant, that was an automatic bucket. But essentially, you have three great defenders that are also no scrubs on the opposite side, because you could lock up the Nets all you want. You could put Ben Simmons on them and clamp up all you want. Matisse Thybulle if the Sixers matched up. But if those guys can't get you cooking on the other end, it's not going to do it. And I'm not going to try to take too much away from regular season. I know they didn't have James Harden. But I think you could take away from that those guys, they can hoop both ends. But I think the biggest difference against these Nets is going to come in from them just not being fully healthy hardly at all this year. Offensively for the Nets, I don't think that's going to kill them. I think it's going to come down to the Bucks being able to limit them defensively, which I think the Bucks are going to be able to do because they've spent the majority of the season fully healthy and have gotten their chemistry down and communicating well. But the Nets defensively, I think they're going to be able to get taken advantage of all of screens, communications, because they just haven't been out there defensively that long. They don't know each other's tendencies. And on top of that, even if they were, they have a matchup problem that the Bucks don't have. The Nets have great players that might just be able to just get buckets against good defense regardless. But the Nets have nobody that can match up with Giannis. The Bucks have players that can match up with their big three. The Nets, you try putting Blake the Snake on Giannis, that's probably their best option. But Blake Griffin, Blake the Snake, is not someone that you want to be guarding Giannis. I don't really think they have anyone that matches up with him. We saw that in the two games that happened in the regular season. Yes, he might not hit his jumpers as well, but I don't think that they have anyone that can bang with him down low. You're going to have to bring double teams. And this season, they're going to have guys, as I mentioned earlier, that are going to be able to knock it down. If you bring in doubles on Giannis, oh, that's going to be trouble. Not for the Bucks, for the Nets. So I think the Bucks are going to win that series, and they'll move on to the Sixers. And lastly, in the conference finals, the Bucks would most likely have to face the Philadelphia 76ers. And those Sixers, in contrast with the Bucks, might have the easiest path to the finals. I'm sorry. Playing the Knicks or the Hawks in the second round is not nearly as difficult as having to play the Nets. And that's really a benefit for those Sixers. But in a conference finals matchup, it could hurt them a little bit. Coming off of playing the Knicks or the Hawks, good teams, but they're not teams that most likely the Sixers are going to have to be playing at the tippy top of their game to be able to squeak by them. And they might be playing a little bit lower of a level, you know, playing slightly down in their competition, not ready for playing up at another level where the Bucks are going to be thriving coming off of a tough series against the Nets. And the Bucks playing at their tippy top level, they might be able to get the Sixers early in a game or two. And throughout the season, the real reason is I think the Bucks just have the two-way guys that the Sixers don't as much. Joel Embiid, dominant. He could dominate both ends. But I think Giannis matches that for the Bucks. And then after that, Tobias Harris, he's been great offensively. Defensively, he's not terrible, but he's really not going to make it happen for you like Chris Middleton can on both ends. And then Ben Simmons, great defender, good offensive player, but he's not a bucket like a Jrue Holiday can be. And then mostly after that is, I don't think they have guys off the bench that are going to get it done, that are really going to be able to make that big of an impact to take you to the finals. You got George Hill coming off the bench who hasn't looked so great since he's joined them. You've got Matisse Thybulle, who's a great defender, but again, not a two-way guy. The Bucks off the bench, they have P.J. Tucker. You could count on him to hit you an open corner tray, or just any corner tray for that matter. Brittany Forbes, 45% from three. Pat Connaughton's been solid. Bobby Portis, one of the best stretch fours in the league. So I think the Bucks are going to be able to take that series, and they're going to the finals this year. Now, don't get me wrong. It is going to be a difficult path. I'm not saying I could guarantee the Bucks are winning, but they're my pick. I truly believe that this is the Bucks' year, and for all those reasons, I think the Bucks are winning the East, and I think they're going to win the NBA championship, but we'll make that announcement later. But let me know what y'all think. Drop a comment, hit that like, and can you please subscribe? Yes, sir.